Hi students, I am Harish Tantri, lecturer in Electrical and Electronics Engineering, SNM Polytechnic, Modbidri. In this presentation, let us study about table fan and ceiling fan. The aim of this experiment is to dismantle a given table fan and ceiling fan, identify the parts, assemble it back into working condition, note down the nameplate details, and troubleshoot and suggest suitable remedies for it. After completion of this experiment, you have to be able to dismantle and reassemble a table fan or a ceiling fan. You have to be able to identify the parts and troubleshoot the faults in the table fan and repair it. So this is the table fan. You might have seen everywhere, and these are the parts of the table fan. You can see the different parts, like the front guard, blade, back guard, motor assembly, stand, etc. Let us see how the table fan works. Table fan is one of the common electric appliance used in houses, offices, shops, business establishments to provide air circulation. This table fan has a single phase permanent capacitor induction motor. This motor has two parts, namely rotor and stator. The stator has two windings, starting winding or auxiliary winding and running winding. A capacitor is connected in series with the starting winding, which creates a phase angle difference between the currents flowing through the starting and running windings. With this phase angle difference, these two windings collectively produce a rotating magnetic field. This rotating magnetic field induces an EMF in the rotor winding, and the rotor current produces a flux, and hence the rotor, it rotates along with the stator flux. The capacitor is permanently connected here at both starting and running conditions. Therefore, this motor operates as a balanced two-phase motor. This motor produces a uniform torque and has a noise-free operation. The speed of the fan is controlled by connecting a resistance with multi-tappings in series with the supply, or by having tapping in the winding as shown in the circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. The supply is connected to the motor through a speed selector switch. So here the tappings are used in the winding. The two coils L1 and L2 are used to connect in series with the running winding, which reduces the current through the running winding, and hence the speed of the motor also decreases with insertion of these two coils. And the auxiliary winding or starting winding is connected in series with a capacitor of 2 microfarad, 400 volt. Next, procedure. Before handling a table fan, disconnect the fan from the supply. Conduct the visual inspection on the mains cord, insulation and plug pin terminals. Carefully observe. If there is any failure of insulation or damaged cord or the damaged plug pin, so replace it. Then remove the front guard and blade assembly. Place the fan in a lying position on a pad or cloth. Remove the front and back cover of the motor assembly. Then open the bottom cover. You can see the regulator section with a selector switch and a resistance. Remove the motor and oscillating units. Check the continuity of the winding using series sys clamp, and also check the insulation resistance of the fan by connecting the test lamp between the winding and body of the motor. Assemble the table fan back into working condition and finally check the condition of the fan. Now let us see the troubleshooting chart, the different faults in the table fan and possible causes, and how these faults can be rectified. The first one, the fan is not working when you switch on the fan by connecting it to the supply. If the fan is not working, the first we have to check the supply. The reason may be absence of supply. Check the supply by using a test lamp. And if the supply is not that, it may be one of the reason for not working of the fan. Defective supply cord. The supply cord may be defective. Check the supply cord using a series test lamp and replace if necessary. You can check the continuity of the wire by connecting it to a series test lamp. Defective regulator resistance or the switch. Check the resistance using a series test lamp and replace if necessary. If it is faulty, then replace. Defective motor. The motor has two windings. Check the continuity of the winding using series test lamp and if required, rewind or replace the motor. Check the capacitor using a series test lamp and replace if necessary. Then check for any loose connections in the supply cord, in the winding terminals, capacitor connection, and if found any loose connections, make it correct. And the next problem is the fan is noisy. The main reason for this is dry or worn out bush bearing. Lubricate the bush bearing with suitable oil, and if the bush bearing is worn out, replace with the new one. And next, the fan is not oscillating. Maybe the fault in the gear wheels, in the oscillating mechanism. Check the gear wheels and replace if necessary. The fan is wobbling mainly because the improper blades, bending of the blades. Remove the bend of the blades if possible, or replace with a new one. And the fan gives shock. The main reason for electric shock is the leakage in the winding, or the terminals, live wires, may be touching the body of the fan. For leakage in the winding, check the winding by using a series test clamp, or you can check the insulation resistance of the winding using a megger and insulate the winding properly, or rewind if necessary. If any wires touching the body, then insulate it properly with proper insulation.
Hi students, in this video I will demonstrate how to disassemble a table fan, identifying the parts, checking the winding or components, and reassemble back into working condition. First, let us dismantle the table fan. So this is the table fan. Before dismantling, check the working condition of the fan. So I will connect it to the supply and checking the working condition. So fan is in the working condition. So now remove the table fan from the supply. In dismantling, first remove the front guard. So this is the guard. So I'm removing the front guard by removing the clips. So now we have to remove the blade by removing a screw fixed to the blade. So remove the screw. After removing the screw, gently push the blade. Made of aluminium, lightweight. So now we have to remove the back guard. Thank you. So this is the back guard. Next. So this is the motor part. First remove the back cover by removing the screw. Remove the back cover carefully. After this, remove the wires.
Sir.
Before removing the wires, note down the connections. So this is the supply terminal. So this is the capacitor terminal. I'll remove the capacitor also. It's connected between the red and blue terminals of the winding. So these three are the winding terminals. This winding has three terminals brought out. Actually, there is two winding, running winding and starting winding. So one terminal is common. So this white wire is common for both starting and running winding. This red color is the running winding connection and blue color is the starting winding connection. The capacitor is connected between the red and blue terminals of the winding. So I'll remove the winding connections by removing the screw. So winding terminals are removed. So now I'll remove the motor. So this is the split pin. So I removed the split pin and a washer. So now the motor can be removed. So separated the motor. So now we have to remove this plate. There are two screws provided for this. So remove the screws and keep the screws carefully. So this is the fan motor. So this is the shaft. You can see the bush here. So this is the front bush. And this is the hole for putting the oil for lubrication of the bush. And this is the winding. So this is the outer cover. So this is the capacitor. I'll remove the capacitor. So now remove the rotor. I'll remove the rotor. For removing the rotor, remove the nut. Now I am removing the rotor part.
this is the rotor and this is the stator. Stator, you can see the stator poles and winding. So totally there are 8 coils, 4 running winding and the remaining 4 coils for starting winding. So this part contains the one more bush. So this is the bush and oscillating mechanism. So this is the oscillating mechanism consisting of gear wheels, so which is rotated by the main shaft. The main shaft also has the thread. So this rotates the inner wheel of the oscillating mechanism, which oscillates the fan. Now we'll check the windings, continuity of the windings by using series test clamp.
Ready.
Connect the testing terminals to the common terminal and the red color wire. This is the running winding. So you can see the continuity. Lamp is glowing. If there is no continuity, the lamp will not glow. And now we'll check the starting winding. So this is the starting winding. The lamp is glowing. That means the winding has continuity. If I connect the test lamp between this running and starting winding, the lamp is glowing dim. Now the two windings are connected in series. Now check the earth fault. Connect the one terminal of the test lamp to the body and the other terminal to the winding terminal. So there is no continuity. The lamp is not glowing. Also, there is no spark. That means there is no earth leakage in the winding. Now we'll check the capacitor. So this is the fan capacitor. 1.85 microfarad plus or minus 5%. 440 volt AC, 50 hertz. For checking the capacitor, connect the series test terminal between the two terminals. You can see the lamp glowing. Now short the two terminals of the capacitor. You can observe a spark. So this shows that the capacitor is in good condition. Now I'll open the bottom cover of the table fan. Here we can see the regulator section, which is used for controlling the speed of the fan. So remove the screws provided. This is the regulator section consisting of a resistance of 360 ohms, 240 ohms plus 120 ohms and a switch. The purpose of this switch, so this is the selector switch. The purpose of this selector switch is to connect the different values of resistance for getting different speeds. If the full value of resistance is connected in series, the fan will rotate
with lesser speed. As the resistance is reduced, the speed of the fan increases, and in the highest speed position, no resistance is connected in series. So we can check the continuity of this resistance by using series test lamp.
Okay, sir.
So connect the test lamp between the two terminals of the resistance. So I'm connecting, testing the resistance. You can see the lamp is glowing dim if the resistance is correct. If there is open circuit, the lamp will not glow. So this is by checking the continuity, we can check the condition of the resistance. We have studied the different parts. So this is the stand. So I'll reassemble the table fan. First I'll put the cover, back cover of the regulator section. Assemble the motor section. Assemble back. Put the washers and nut. And tight it properly. Check the free rotation of the shaft. The rotor must rotate freely. If it is not rotating freely, adjust the nuts such that the rotor will rotate free. Put the front cover. And screws. Make the connections. data. Note that the capacitor is connected to the starting winding in series with the starting winding. And the other terminal of the capacitor is connected to one of the supply terminals. Assemble the motor. Put the washer and split pin. Make the connections, supply terminals. Now fix the guard. And blade assembly. Fix the blades. The screw must be properly aligned with the slot provided in the shaft. Here, slot in the shaft for the screw properly aligned with the slot and right disc. Fix the front guard. And finally, check the fan for working. manage in the working conditions.